Okay, so now that we've got our plant view for our lines, we've got all our visualization, we got our plant objects in. The last thing that we need to do is create the user interface. So I have a plant object screen that I'm gonna open and had a test tag there. I'm gonna get rid of that. And if you go to my controls, we have a plant overview object, so I'll place it over here. And it's just kind of a selection grid. And what we're going to do is we're going to add a couple of other controls, and then we'll kind of fill this thing out. So we're going to add a screen window control, and that's going to be showing our screens. And let's just take a look at the size that we have there. It's 640 by 320. So that should kind of hold what we have. And then we're going to put an alarm control below it, and that's going to show the alarms that we had. So I'll go ahead and make this about the same size just to kind of fill it out. And then what you're going to want to do is on your plant overview, we're going to go up and we'll go to our companion controls here. We're going to add a new one, and we can do alarm control. And then once you do that, then you just select the alarm control that you put. And then we'll do the same thing here for our screen window. And so that lets the control know when a node has a screen, it knows where to show it. When it has an alarm, it kind of knows where to show that as well. Okay, so we're almost there. We just need a way to update the values in our tags that we created in DB1. So in these tags, and so what I'm gonna do, I don't really have a simulation program or anything running in the PLC. So we'll just go to watch table. I can just go in and add these tags so that I can kind of read them. So there's my production lines, line one conveyor, I'll do name, and I'll go through and add all of these. So there's line one conveyor, there's state, and line one conveyor value. What you want to do is go ahead and add all the equipment in here that you want to kind of play around with so that there's some values in there if you want. And then we can manipulate these to see how our plant objects and our plant view work in runtime. So go ahead, if you've been following along, I would like you to create your plant object screen. And make sure you add your companion controls on your properties and define them under companion controls. And then go to your watch table and go ahead and add your tags in. And when you come back, we will go to runtime and test everything out. So once we have our tags in here, let's go ahead and put some meaningful values in our modify values, and then we can modify them. So here, this is our name. So that's going to be conveyor one. I'm not going to worry about the modify value for our boolean because it's going to default to false. And then for our value, I'm just going to add an integer there. And then here, this is going to be motor one. We will give it a value. And then here's our pump name. So this is pump one. And we'll just give it 44. And then this is conveyor two. 66, and then motor 2, 54, and then pump 2, and we'll give it 23. And then we can do monitor all, and it'll show us what we have. And then if we want to modify all selected values, we can select all these guys, and it will write everything directly to the tags. So then we can go to our runtime and start simulation. And load it. And we'll pull up our browser and go to runtime. And then we go to plant objects, and our plant view object will automatically read exactly what we have, and you can see that we have the same hierarchy. And if we select something, notice that it's got the data in there. It's showing conveyor one. So there's our motor one, there's our pump one, and our other objects. So we can immediately see these. And then if we go back over to our force table, I'm going to try to put everything on the screen at once here. If you see, we're on pump two, so that's going to be this guy right here. As I turn it on and off, you can see that it's actually turning it on. So let me refactor this a little bit so we can see both at the same time. There we go. So you can see that we're changing this guy here. And also, if I change my value here, you'll see it change here. And we can also try out our alarm. So I'll put that to 102. And we can see that we do have this alarm. Line is going too fast. And then we can select that. And then if we come out of the alarm condition by going under it, so we can acknowledge it and it goes away. So the whole point of plant view is to allow you to create a hierarchy and a navigation of all your plant equipment. And you can see it plant by plant, line by line, equipment by equipment very quickly once you have all the technology in place. So we're using UDTs, we're using our faceplates, and we're using our plant objects to kind of create something that can allow us to very rapidly engineer a UI to see and drill down to specific equipment. So now it's your turn to complete this. So go and make sure that you have your force table created, get it reading and writing values, and then of course go into simulate mode and go and test everything out in runtime. So here's your assignment 4. You're going to create your plant view screen, update your watch table, and then test in runtime. So create your plant view screen using the plant view object and add a screen window object and alarm control as companion objects to the plant view object. Add your equipment tags from DB1 to the watch table and add default values for your equipment names and values. Make sure to monitor all and write the default values to the PLC. Then simulate the RT module so that you can go to runtime and test the plant view screen. If you need help on specific steps, please refer back to the video as needed.